Welcome to Yellow Brick Road. I'm Jordan, and today I'm going to talk about this recent Iraqi storming of the embassy in Baghdad. But first, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. The GoFundMe link is in the description box. Click the link, read the story, donate some money. None of the money goes to us, it goes to charity. You're helping someone out when you do so, not us. One of our subscribers and his wife helps them pay medical bills. So if you want to help someone out this holiday season, please consider donating to Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. That's right. Atlanta Braves, baby. Number one. All right. So as we know, an alleged Iranian-backed group shot rockets at a U.S. embassy. The U.S. military responded with airstrikes. And it's led to this storming of the U.S. embassy there. Let me just read a little quote here. It's from FT.com. I don't really know them too well, but I wanted this quote. It says, Iran and their proxy forces must cease their attacks on U.S. and coalition forces and respect Iraq's sovereignty to prevent additional defensive actions by U.S. forces. It's like, respect Iraq's sovereignty. So we've been following it, but they've been breaking it. We've been following the rules, they've been fucking with the sovereignty. Does that make any sense to you? Anyone remember the 2003 invasion on false pretenses? It's like, is that an invasion of sovereignty? Very weird, man. Very weird. And now, since that happened, we could basically do whatever we want, right? We just shot, you know, missiles as retaliation, right? Was there any big meeting about it? Did they sit down in Congress and say, let's talk to the leaders of Iraq and get an understanding or get permission to do this military action? Doesn't sound like it. It sounds like we basically own that country. In fact, the embassy itself is like a city within another country's city. I remember learning that years ago. Right, there's a movie with Matt Damon called Green Zone. I think that has something to do with that embassy. I didn't watch the movie, but that's usually what they call this thing, like the Green Zone. Right, this fucking city within another country's city. And it's like, oh, that's ours. That's our territory now. So, of course, you're going to have the State Department puppets. You're going to have guys like Donald Trump. To those many millions of people in Iraq who want freedom and who don't want to be dominated and controlled by Iran, this is your time. Boy, this sounds familiar. That sort of makes you understand that it's from the State Department, right? You shift the narrative to Iran, right? This is all because of Iran. Nothing to do with us going there in 2003, right? That was a mistake. What Iran does is corruption. When we do something, it's a mistake. We fucked up. Our plan was for the sky to open up and to start raining lollipops and kisses and hugs. You're going to rain from the sky. But we made a mistake, and we accidentally killed, you know, a million people by accident. Mistake. So you already see him. He's selling a narrative, right? I've said this before. I don't think he would go to war with Iran until after he wins an election. If he wins the second term, that would be the time he does that. That's what I would think. And his dipshit fans are gonna sell Trump and sell Trump and sell Trump until that. It's like, Oh wait, he just destroyed Iran. It's like, oh, maybe he wasn't that great. You're going to wait till that point happens. You're seeing all the signs, all the funding of Al-Qaeda, all the false flag events, the chemical attacks in Syria, all the selling the narrative of Iran being the biggest threat. Meanwhile, he was the one who pulled out of the Iran nuclear deal. all of a sudden they're going to become a nuclear threat again. Like, you see all the signs, but they will wait until they see Trump on video shooting a kid in the face, him himself personally. Because if he doesn't do it, then they could, you know, mental gymnastics and say, oh, it was a fake video. It was a... How do you... Did you see him do it? Like, that type of shit. Seriously, that's what people are doing. And the normies that are Trump supporters, they don't pay attention to any type of foreign policy. They just say, oh, Iran's bad. And that's it. All right, they know basically next to nothing. They're essentially Biden voters or Obama vote. Well, second-term Obama voters. All right, then you have another mouthpiece for the State Department, Mr. Marco Rubio. He says, these aren't protesters. These are members of a militia supported and controlled by Iran. And he's talking about, you know, the people storming the embassy. I can't say I know, but... Oh, well, I wouldn't be surprised if there's some Iranian-backed guys. I can't say I know. But if I had to guess, it's probably a... This is probably like a pin pulled off a grenade. And you have these Iraqi people who are like, what the, like, you're still doing this shit? Like, fuck this, we're storming your place. But I still wouldn't be surprised by, you know, geopolitical maneuvers from any of these fucking countries, from any of these fucking governments. Not the normal people, but the governments themselves. Right? People shouldn't be like, yeah, Iran's good because the U.S. is bad. Like, no, they could all suck. In fact, I believe they all do suck. Syria, Saudi Arabia, Israel, the U.S., the U.K., France, South America, fucking Africa. All these government leaders, they tend to suck ass, to be honest with you. The CNN headline incorrectly implies this is a spontaneous and organic reaction. It's not. It's an orchestrated attack developed as a contingency option months ago by Iran's, the Iran Revolutionary Guard Corps thing. I think that's what it means. So as you can see, these people are robots, right? They're not really smart at all. Maybe clever at times, but they're not really smart. They're just using narratives that we accuse them of, and then they sell it back to us. Right? When they start telling us that, oh, these moderate rebels, they just want freedom to fight in Syria. They want to fight for their country back. Then you realize, like, wait, these dudes aren't even from Syria. Who are these guys? Why do they have weapons all of a sudden? Where'd they get those from? That type of shit. Or, I can't even say his name, like Zygmunt Brzezinski, when he's talking to the Mujahideen in Afghanistan. He's saying, this is for your people, for your spirituality, for your religion, for Allah. Like, that's what you're fighting for, and that's what you're all about, and that's why the U.S. supports you. Meanwhile, it's like, oh, seemingly legitimate protesters... or a legitimate freedom army or something, ends up being like, oh, you're really just a proxy army for the U.S. to take down the Soviet Union. So they're sort of using the narratives we say about them. That's what Marco Rubio's using right here. Right? These are fake protesters here to disrupt the U.S. They're really Iranian-backed and blah, blah, blah. They're Iranians dressed up as Iraqis. Say, oh, that's the shit we say about you. Yeah, look at his fucking profile thing. I'm going to show you this real fast because I can't wait. First line of his little profile says, follower of Christ. I'm like, yeah. Yeah. He'd be crying. He'd be like, oh, God, not me. I know a pussy when you see one. Trump too. He'd run though, because he doesn't. I don't think he believes in anything. He'd run. Rubio might be on his knees crying. Little fucking bitch. All right, and just for a good measure, we have this this tweet, this video from Sarah Abdallah, comparing like our excuses to get into Iraq with this new administration's excuses to get into Iran. Check this out.
And we know that Iraq is continuing to finance terror and gives assistance to groups that use terrorism to undermine Middle East peace.
The Iranian regime continues to fuel conflict, terror, and turmoil throughout the Middle East and beyond.
He doesn't believe a word he's fucking saying. He's just reading it. Like, guy, how do you not see him as just a tool? Seriously. Do you look at that guy? He confidently says that. Like, he knows what he's talking about. I'm like, no. No. I'm reading what they're telling me to say. Straight up. In fact, that might be worse than a corrupt action, is when you're just a robotic puppet of a corrupt action. When there's no you there and you're just reading what they tell me to say. Because he knows he'll be safe. No matter what the fuck happens, war or no war, he's safe. He'll be fine. You know, his diet might kill him, but you know, there's not going to be any military forces coming to get him. He'll be fine. He'll be safe. He'll have Secret Service for the rest of his life. And yeah, he cares about you somehow. Somehow that guy cares about you.
Many nations are joining us in insisting that Saddam Hussein's regime be held accountable.
Iran will be held accountable.
The danger is already significant, and it only grows worse with time.
This is a threat to the region and a threat to the world. And it.
All right. That's the most obvious, like, you know, pussy, like, ever, right? Tell me that's not the softest fucking looking dude ever. Or it's like, oh, like, random, like bullies, high school bullies could punk him as a grown-ass man. Seriously.
We must bomb them.
Fucking pussy ass. Someone told him he would look tougher if he grew a mustache. Let's put it that way.
It gets worse day by day by day.
The same tyrant has tried to dominate the Middle East.
And Iran's ambition to dominate the Middle East remains.
Meanwhile, we fund Saudi Arabia and Israel. And if you step back and really look at it, it looks like Israel's trying to be the dominant force in the Middle East, right? All the country, like, we're taking down country by country, even multilateral, you know, all over the place, taking over the Middle East. We leave Israel alone. In fact, we give them more shit, more weapons, more funding, more territory, Golan Heights, more shit, more and more and more shit we take and take from the other countries. And I guess you can include Saudi Arabia in there, but they look like you're a pawn for now. But at some point, like, you'll go down too. That's what it looks like to me.
They could attack our allies or attempt to blackmail the United States.
America will not be held hostage to nuclear blackmail.
You tell me, was that his volition to say that? Did he mean what he just said right there? Or was he squinting and reading that shit? Those aren't his words. To be honest with you, he probably doesn't care about war one way or another. Which on its own, for me, would be like, oh, that's like a corrupt action of apathy. It's like when you just, he's smart, I would say he's smart enough to know, like, what the fuck they're doing, right? He's like, Iran, yeah. Yo, do we have evidence of this? Oh, no problem, whatever, tell me what I gotta say, and I'll say it. He'll say whatever they tell him to say. He's a puppet, he's a tool. But don't lose your focus on him either. He's definitely culpable.
Regime change in Iraq is the only certain means of removing a great danger to our nation.
And therefore, the only solution is to change the regime itself.
Because I really do believe we will be greeted as liberators.
Freedom is right around the corner.
We don't need another senseless war. Now to finish up this video, I'm going to check out what someone says who I would consider someone who means well, but I think made an ignorant statement. Let's look at this. This is from Cassandra Fairbanks. She says, she's quote tweeting someone who said, a civil war is brewing there, just like here. And it's like, man, is it a civil war? Is it really a civil war? Is the Syrian war really a civil war? Would this be a civil war? It's like, nah, too many hands moving too many pieces around for it to just be an organic civil war. So I don't like that term, civil war, there. But anyways, Cassandra says, not our problem. I honestly do not give a flying fuck about Iraq, Iran, Israel, Saudi Arabia, or any other nation in the Middle East. Our troops should never have been there in the first place. Bring them home. None of it is our problem. And I say, Cassandra, it is our problem. If you said this before we took any military action or geopolitical actions or financial actions in the Middle East, if you said this before then, I'd be like, okay, you have a little bit more credibility to you there. But when you say this after all the fucking shit we've done, all the shit we've done, I commented here. I think we should be happy to help other nations. The problem is that people get tricked into thinking our country has been trying to help these countries the entire time. They haven't. Right? This wasn't, we went there to help and we made a mistake. Like, no. What's happened is the actual thing they wanted to happen, for the most part. Right? Obviously, they can't control every little human being on the planet. But for the big picture stories are exactly going the exact way they would want it to go. These State Department, neocon, neoliberal types. 100%. But, my solution was, we should be helping these people. And the way to help them is to open a diplomatic relationship. And it's like, oh, how do we do that? We spill our guts of every fucking bullshit, corrupt, plus ignorance action we've ever done. In the region, I'd say in the world, to where it's like, okay, they're really going to change. Not when they just get on a podium and say, we're going to deliver freedom. And they're like, oh, fuck, we know what that means. We better get out of here. We better start moving towards Europe or something. Let's leave the house I grew up in and look for somewhere to go in Europe. That's what happens when they hear, we're here, we're going to spread democracy in the Middle East. But if they hear us explain all of our geopolitical maneuvers and all of that, all our military actions, all our corrupt actions, when I say our, I mean the governments. I'm not going to put any blame on normal people other than their ignorance of what happened, right? The 70%+ acceptance of the Iraq war because they were tricked into it because of 9/11. It's like, yeah, I'm blaming you for that. But as far as in your minds, you probably were never thinking that they would just do the shit that they've done, right? Just massacre people and prop up other people that massacre people. You probably didn't have that anywhere near your minds. But continuing, our government needs to fess up to the shit it's done. 100%. Once you fess up, all the assholes connected to it will have no choice but to duck and hide. I'd want to just give them immunity, like go off to your mansions and just don't bother in society until you're ready to really change. But I don't agree with Cassandra here, because it's like we go into a house, we burn it down, and then we just leave and say, it's not our problem anymore. Sorry. Like, hey, we're doing the right thing, right? We're staying out of your affairs.
Yeah, but you burnt a house down.
That was the old guys, not us. We're out of here. Sorry, bye. And that's the way it'll seem like to them, probably. Like, you come here, you cause all this shit to happen, and then you just leave, and then you think it's a noble thing to do. It's like, no, you need to fess up for your fucking, the government's corrupt actions, and the populace's mistake of allowing it to happen. All right, that's it for me. Please subscribe if you like, comment, agree, disagree. Tell me what you think. Send me information. I want to hear more about all this fucking bullshit happening in the Middle East. Don't forget to donate Devin's Journey to Recovery. GoFundMe link in the description box. And with all that said, give this video a thumbs down. Say you want to get him.